Eyes up.
All in.
The word, I've been thinking about all day. All day is honor. Honor. Right? Honor. Think about how honored I am to be your coach. Think about how honored these coaches are to get to call you our guys. You with me?
Yes, sir.
Think about the honor that you have brought this university. The honor you have brought to your families by the way you do things, by the way you love each other, by the way you compete, by the way you're accountable, by the way you go to battle for each other. You understand me?
Yes, sir.
I'm proud of what you guys are doing. I'm proud of the way you represent. I'm proud of the way you guys battle. I'm proud of the way you do things in a way that honors God. You have no idea what it means to me. What brings honor? Going to battle for one another brings honor. Being accountable brings honor. Just thinking, having a desire to finish brings honor. Competing, bringing it no matter what brings honor. Handling adversity brings honor. Responding brings honor. Being selfless brings honor. Being a warrior, having a warrior spirit brings honor. You understand me?
Yes, sir.
Just thinking, doing things because you love one another brings honor. Let's bring honor today. Let's bring honor today. You understand me?
Yes, sir.
Play for each other. Play with it. Play with an unbelievable love for one another and let it go. Let it go. Let it go. You with me?
Yes, sir.
Get a hold of your brother. Let's go.
Back in my helmet, cleats, and shoulder pads.
Throwing deep, it is complete, Citty, at the 10, at the 5, touchdown, Harding. Cage Citty, the senior from Harding Academy.
We've never had anybody ever come through our program that has made a bigger jump from where he started to where he finished. I mean, he has worked and worked and worked and worked. He is such a special young man. His care factor, the kind of teammate he is unbelievable. And I'm really, really proud of Cade City, and he's earned every bit of it.
The kings of the school, man, where the boys are fall.
They are going to fake it, and running to the right side, and nothing. The Bison stop it. Jake Madding came up and made the tackle.
You know, Jake is such a faithful warrior, going to do whatever it takes for the team to win. Really excited to see his role getting to be a little bit bigger. So that was a big play. Him taking the ball away on the onside kick was a huge play.
The character, the attitude of selflessness that it takes to be a receiver here. You know, you've got to be a special, special guy that loves your teammates and is willing to sacrifice. And every guy in that group fits that mold. And that is an awesome, awesome bunch of young men that I take to war every day of the week. I love those guys so much.
Oh, first down, throwing downfield, man wide open, complete, touchdown, Harding. James Townsdin, the junior from Memphis.
You know, James Townsdin, you know, he's one of these receivers that just works and works and works to have a chance, and for him to lay out and make that catch, really, really proud.
To throw it here on second down, throwing into the end zone, and it's intercepted, picked off. It's picked off by Kage.
Kage's such a great story. He's been a monster all year for us. He's a tremendous leader, tremendous captain. Really, really proud of Kage.
Intercepted. It was deflected and picked off, and this is going to be returned for a touchdown.
Great job,
Cade Pugh.
I'm crazy proud of Cade and Dalton both. You know, those guys are roommates, and they actually live a little apartment out on our property there, and they've just been such a part of our lives, and just the character, the leadership, the buy-in is unbelievable. And, you know, I always say that's the worst part of this job. You love them the most. They get ready to leave you. But yeah, both those guys are exactly who we want to be about. You know, we talk about doing things and looking to honor God. I promise you that Dalton Allen and KP, they live in a way that honors God. And I'm just crazy proud of them.
So the pass hit as he throws downfield and intercepted. Grant Fitzhugh picked it off, and the Bisons will take over.
Bill and Grant, you know, these young men come out, both have awesome days for us. And then the next day, Will is preaching down at Stuttgart. Grant is leading group at College Church. They're really, really proud of those two guys for the way they do things and the way they're honoring God. That's what we want to be all about.
Coming to the near side, going to throw downfield for Cendrick. He caught it at the 10-yard line. First down, Bisons, and a big gainer. Mike Cendrick, boy, he will hit you. And he popped him right there.
He is one of the greatest we've ever had. He probably got more votes for captain this year than anybody I've ever coached in my life. I mean, he is such a selfless, special leader. He is a uniter. He loves the Lord, and it's evident in the way he lives. This obviously is this senior bunch is a really special group. Seven of those guys were freshmen in 2017, which was my first year, so we've been together the whole time. And you know, their contribution to Harding football is unbelievable, really, just especially with the way they've influenced the culture here. They've just been tremendous leaders, especially spiritually for this group. And the goal for us is to have the very best culture in America, and I'm talking about accountability and loving each other and having a warrior spirit, and most of all, you know, can we live in a way that tries to honor God? And you know, if that's how we're judging these young men, then this bunch of seniors is the best we've ever had. I mean, those young men have done more to impact Harding football culture than any group that has ever been here, and I stand by that. They are tremendous, special young men.
Father God, we love you so much. Amen.
Amen.
We just thank you, God, for the way you bless us. We feel so blessed. So feel so blessed to be your men, God. We want to be your men. We want to do things in a way that brings honor to you with the way we work, act, love, speak, compete, handle adversity, hold the rope, all the things that we believe honors you. We want to do today, God. We want to do it in a way that brings honor to you. And God, in all things, we want to give glory to you. Thank you, Father, for your son who was the ultimate warrior, who had a warrior spirit, who showed us how to live, how to finish, how to handle adversity, and most of all, how to love. I pray we'll play with a bunch of love for one another today. We love you, God. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
The identity of this team.
If I had to describe kind of what the brotherhood means to me, I think one of the first things is the brotherhood really is something that in any season, the brotherhood's the brotherhood. It doesn't matter if it's in a season full of losses, a season full of wins. It doesn't matter if it's in an off season. You know, it's like, I know I've got guys on the offensive side of the ball and the defensive side of the ball, guys younger than me or guys older that have left that I can count on for the rest of my life.
Our coach is always talking about wash feet culture. And so wash feet culture means when Jesus washed the feet of the disciples, he knew what he was getting into, and what was going to happen, what was going to be the end result. And so our coaches are always just preaching, you know, be servant leaders, whether you're on the highest of highs or the lowest of lows, always just be willing to serve, whether that's in the community, on the field, making a good block, or just, you know, just in general with the people around you. So that's what the brotherhood means to me.
When I think about the question, I guess the first thing that pops in my head is just learning how to love one another. And I guess that probably wouldn't be the first thing you think about when you think about football, but just being at Harding and being a part of this football team, when you think about brotherhood, you just think about loving the person beside you first.
You know, a lot of it too is putting the needs of someone else before your own. And so what may seem like something, you know, that's good for yourself at the time, you know, really thinking and thinking what's best for the team, thinking what's best for your brother, thinking what's best for people that we play with. I think that plays into a lot of the success that we have.
I guess a brotherhood means to me that, you know, you're willing to do something for someone else that's completely different than you are, just obtaining one goal.
So to me, the brotherhood is all about loving each other. And I think that we have just a really deep love for each other, and that's what makes this brotherhood special. Brotherhood is about sacrificing, putting each other before ourselves. And when I think about brotherhood, I think about guys like Christian Witt, who hasn't played here for a couple years, but I think about times where we would be at football church together and I'm a freshman and he's a senior, but we have this bond because we're in the brotherhood. And he texted me when we had a tough game a couple weeks ago, and he just was encouraging me because that's what brotherhood is.
A group of guys that are big team, little me guys, you know, guys that are all about the team, not about me. And you know, that's not just a position group thing, that's a culture thing I see in Harding football, of guys that are in it for something bigger than themselves, that they're willing to have a lesser role to accomplish something, that a group of people, when they all come together, there's just this magic synergy that kind of comes together that is pretty special when guys aren't making it about themselves, but making it about the team.